Hello everyone, this is Amritpal Singh. Welcome to the next video on Apache Pig. Guys, in this video I'll be talking about two of the important operators of Apache Pig, which are group and co-group. So guys, you must be wondering that what I have opened up in front of you. Guys, these are the input files which I'll be using for my today's demonstration. So I've already have opened up my Hadoop and I've already have created two directories with the name z1 and z2, which is containing the files ab and lt.csv respectively, and these are the contents of these two files, right? Guys, group by and co-group, or group or co-group, are actually quite similar to each other. The difference is, like, group we apply on a single relation, co-group we apply on the more than one relation. Co-group works like in the same way as of group if we are applying on single relation. So if you apply group on single relation and if you apply co-group on single relation, you'll be getting same answer, but the answer will be different if you are applying the co-group on more than one relation. So co-group is used to apply on more than one relation, right? So group by or group, right, in the pig actually has been inspired from the SQL's group by, that we have to aggregate all the records together, which is similar in nature. So it works in the same fashion, right? On the other hand, co-group is equivalent of group plus join. I can say, like, co-group can be defined as group plus join. So let's see that how these two things are different from each other and how they are similar. For this, guys, first of all, we have to open up the pig. And we all know that if we write pig on the console, it will be opening up the pig in MapReduce mode, right? So these are the contents, right? So just to avoid confusion, that's why I've just shown it in front of you in prior, right? So guys, we have received the grunt shell. Let's load the data first. So we have to load the data on two relations. The first relation, I'm keeping it as w1 load, and it is available under user user amrit. Then we have z1, under which we have ab.csv. Alright, then we have using, followed by pig storage. Alright, then we all know that this relation is separated by a comma as a delimiter, space as. Then after this, we have to specify the schema, and the schema is we have two fields of type char array. So I'm keeping it as owner of type char array and animal of type char array. Alright, so these are the two fields, and we all know that we have to end up every pig Latin statement with semicolon. It's done. Similarly, we have to load the second file under the second relation w2. So I'm keeping it as z2. Then we have lt. Alright, then we have to keep one common column, so I'm just changing this as name. Done. Alright, done. So guys, let's apply the group. As I've already have told you that group has been inspired from the SQL's group by, and it can be applied on a single relation. So we all know that there's a duplicacy available in the second column, animal column. So let's see how the group works. So I'm keeping R as a relation name. Then simple, we have to write a syntax, very simple. Group space relation name by column name. And we have to group the relation with respect to what? The column. All right, done. Let's see what we have got under R. So you will be finding that in this animal column, as we are having three unique entries, cat, dog and fish. So wherever we have the occurrence of cat, you'll be getting their record separately. Wherever we have an occurrence of dog, you'll be getting their record separately and fish separately. Let's see. So we have dump it. We all know dump is equivalent of select star from table name of your SQL, that we all have learned in a previous video of Apache Pig. So guys, let's see what we have got. So this is the result we got. As I've already have told you that we have a two occurrence of cat, so we got two entries of cat. Similarly, we have a two occurrence of dog, we have got two entries of dog, and we have got only one entry of fish, so we got just one record in the fish. So this is the result of group. So guys, if you apply in the same fashion, if you apply co-group, it will also give you the same answer. Let me show you. So I'm just changing this relation to R1. Instead of group, I'm using co-group. Just see the difference. You will not find any difference because the result will be exactly same. I've already told you that group and co-group works in a similar fashion if we are using it on a single relation. So if I dump R1 now, you will find that I'll be getting same answer. All right, so just see, we got a cat, same, L is cat, this and that, right? So in the simplest form, co-group is exactly same as group. It groups the rows based upon a column and creates bags for each group, right? That's why we got the same answer. This is called as a group. So a co-group, right? So last thing is, like, let's try to apply co-group on two different relations. So we are already have a W1 and W2 are two different relations. Let's apply and just see the difference, right? So let's apply this co-group now. We have to now take this, then co-group, all right? First relation, W1 by animal, comma, W2 by animal, because animal is common, right, in the both the relations, all right? So that's it. And let's apply dump to just end up this. And you will be finding that it will be now applied on more than one relation, and just see the answer, guys. So guys, we got cat against cat, whatever the entries we got in the both the relations, we got in a one row, right? Alice cat, Adam cat coming from first relation, Whiskers cat, Paws cat coming from second relation. Similarly against dog, Steve dog, Adam dog coming from the first relation, Rex dog, Fido dog coming from second relation. Similarly against fish, Alex fish coming from first relation and Nemo fish coming from the second relation. So guys, this is all we are having for today. So let me just brief it. That in summary, we can say that we can use co-group when you need to group two tables by a column and then join on a grouped column. And we use group when we have to apply or use it in a single relation, right? I hope guys, you must have understood the concept of group and co-group in Apache Pig. Thanks for watching guys, see you in the next video.